That was all.
Yeah. So what did you bring for us today?
Today, we want to show some kind of different case, because in this case, what we have about 10 to 15 year old implants with cool tender restorations with the bridges on the posterior teeth. And there is a problem. The patient has extreme parafunctions. He is a bruxist. He wears off all of his teeth, breaks down all the bridges. A lot of problems, and we always have problem with the bridges because the bridges are not holding the pressure, the amount of force he is applying on them. So what we want to do in this case, we wanted to remove some part of the gingiva between those multi-units that you can see to make the bridge a little bit thicker. So what we did is we opened the flap between those multi-units and we removed part of the connective tissue but didn't touch the keratinized gingiva. So this way, what we'll achieve is we'll get more amount of material in the gingival part of the crown.
So basically we took away some of the gingiva to make more space for the bridge.
Exactly.
Make the bridge thicker.
Yes, to hold bigger forces.
To be able to withstand bigger forces.
Yes, this is after the procedure when we sawed off the gingiva and we returned back the bridge, and you'll see this is the bridge that he broke down. We made a new one.
You can see it's bulkier.
Yeah, even though it's bulkier, you can see that we have even more material in the gingival part of the bridge. So in this case, we can even add more material and make the bridge even much thicker. Even more thicker.
If you need to.
Yeah.
So patients that have bruxism, you most of the time make their bridges thicker and with weak, smaller embrasures?
Yes. To have as much more material that I can have. And you make them from a monolithic zirconia or even metal to hold the pressure, the forces.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow to stay tuned with the latest cases. Thank you and have a great day.